With Ash vs. Evil Dead being cancelled and Bruce Campbell leaving the character of Ash Williams, a character who he has worked on and been synonymous with for over a decade, fans are now left dazed and with a little disappointment with what writers had planned, seeing a more apocalyptic Mad Max-esque adventure planned for Ash as he continues to fight the undead. So with no resolution in sight, here are my top 5 shows that were cancelled on a cliffhanger ending. Number 5. This is the start of an otherwise naughty trend with Fox cancelling shows, but well, it happened with this rather unique film turned to television series concept, which made stars of Lena Headey and Summer Glau. It is the Sarah Connor Chronicles. The high critical praise and renewal from the initial 8 episodes to 22, this refreshing take on the Terminator franchise gave fans a rather ingrained story that everyone wanted. To see sadly Fox cancel the show after a second season cliffhanger, it left us in limbo, not knowing the fate of both Sarah and John. Several attempts have been made to try and renew the series and also revive the rather dying franchise, with the most recent being the rather sad Terminator Genisys. This on one occasion where it may be best to bring the franchise back to television in hopes that more polarizing stories can be told, maybe with something like Netflix. Number 4. Profit. Most people know Adrian Pasdar for his various forays as anti-hero to downright evil character, from Supergirl to his rather unique situation in Heroes, and also the bad luck of being attached to shows that had the tendency to be doomed. Prophet was, for another Fox mishap, being seen as ahead of its time and a precursor to shows such as The Sopranos and Breaking Bad. It was cancelled just 3 episodes shy due to Fox's unfamiliarity with the amoral lead of Jim Prophet and his ability to do whatever it takes to further his own means and his agenda. Number 3. Hannibal. Like other mentions to this list, the series has its origins in films that came before it. Otherwise known as the Red Dragon Trilogy, Hannibal was a series we never knew that we needed, but we wanted nonetheless. Mads Mikkelsen's Dr. Lecter is the most surprising part of the show, as he was more cunning, charming, and rather unique, and brought something rather polarizing to the show, but due to fledgling ratings, as with most NBC's programming at the time, they really couldn't make it work, and thus the fate of the show is still undecided, with Netflix funding more and more unique programming and Amazon's push into purchasing more old shows. We could see Hannibal make a return, but right now it seems very highly unlikely. Number 2. Angel. Most people would know Joss Whedon as one of the pivotal pieces that helped spearhead the Marvel Cinematic Universe, tying pieces together that individual movies of Iron Man, Captain America, Thor, and the Incredible Hulk. That's also bringing us the rather underwhelming Age of Ultron. There was a time though where Whedon took an established and underrated comedy of Buffy the Vampire Slayer and turned it into a rather unique teen drama, and that had all the heartache and ton of ass kicking, and spun from that was a series known as Angel, in which the titular character and former love interest Angel was given his own adventures, featuring the slew of characters from the Buffyverse that stood on its own 2 feet, and the issues between the network and Whedon, which he states in the interview, were the reason why the show was cancelled. The only reason Angel didn't come back, it's a very simple thing, because our ratings were up, because our critical attention. Joss specifically asked Jordan Levin, who was the head of WB at the time, to give us an early pickup, but because every year they would wait so long to give Angel a pickup, and a lot of us would turn down jobs hoping Angel would continue. He didn't want that to happen, so he was feeling very confident and just asked Jordan, make your decision now whether you're going to pick us up or not. And Jordan, with his hands tied and with his back up against the wall, called him the next day and said, okay, we're cancelling you. Jordan's no longer there, and WB has since recognised, I believe, Garth Ancia at WB said that it was a big mistake to cancel Angel, and there were powers at play that happened to just do that. They wanted to do it, we wanted to get an early pickup, and we didn't. In fact, we forced them to make the decision, and with his hands forced, he made the decision to cancel us. Number 1. Firefly. Another Joss Whedon creation, and one that comes up with every conversation for shows that should be brought back, and ones of whom were cancelled way before the time it actually came to show to meet its storyline conclusion. The show was almost cancelled before it began and was eventually ended by Fox due to having a loyal fan base, but we were told that it wasn't large enough. The episodes were aired out of order, placed in a doomed Friday night dead slot, and case in point, Fox didn't really know what to do with it. And without enough leverage, they basically cancelled it because it wasn't what Fox wanted. They wanted another Buffy and Angel, and well, this wasn't it. So what do you think of my top five? Do you agree? Do you disagree? Name some series below that you felt were cancelled way beyond the time that they should have been. Let us know in the comments below. And as always, like, comment, subscribe, and share. And this has been Michael Burhan for another top five, letting you know that I've got gameplay. Have you?